Hi, my name is Lawrence. Welcome to Kisi Unlocked, where we explain the ins and outs of access control, and show you how to get the most out of your Kisi system.
Today, we will talk about the Altronix 16 Door Trove, the benefits of using it, and how to install it. The Altronix 16 Door Trove is an enclosure that can hold up to 4 Kisi controller pros, allowing up to 16 doors to be controlled simultaneously. The backplane arrived assembled with two 12 or 24 volt DC at 6 amp power supplies, and two 8 views protected output access control modules. The enclosure is mounted on a wall and is made out of metal. The Altronix 16 Door Trove is great for large scale spaces where many doors need to be secured under unified access control. Setups that utilize multiple Kisi controllers can consolidate 4 controllers into one enclosure, improving space efficiency and organization. The enclosure also accommodates up to 4 12-volt DC batteries, enabling backup battery power in the event of a power failure. The Altronix 16 Door Trove offers a simplified board layout, making for easier installation when a large number of Kisi controllers must be configured. Boards are mounted onto a flat backplane, allowing for tidier wire management and organization. The modularity of the enclosure reduces installation time and overall labor costs. Detailed instructions for installing can be found in the manufacturer's manual, linked below in the description. For a general overview of the installation, you can follow the steps of this video. For trove mounting, remove the backplane from the enclosure. Mark and pre-drill holes in the wall. Install the screws and make sure to tighten all screws. Mount the included UL tamper switch opposite of the hinge. Mount Kisi Pro controllers to the backplane. Now let's move on to the power supply. Set the desired DC output by setting the switch to the appropriate position on the power board. Connect unswitched AC power to the terminals, L and N. Use 14 AWG wire for all power connections. 22 to 18 AWG wires can be used for power limited circuits. Measure the output voltage before connecting devices. Connect devices to terminals marked positive DC and negative DC. Optionally connect batteries to the terminals marked negative battery and positive battery. Now let's work on the outputs. For the power supply inputs, these units can be powered with one power supply or two power supplies. In our case, we're using one. Connect the output of the power supply to the terminals marked negative power and positive power. Output options are located on the bottom of the board, and they support switch outputs, form C, and auxiliary power outputs. Attach output devices like maglocks and electronic strikes. Mark these based on specifications for each device. Input trigger options are located on the top of the board. These support normally open input triggers or open controller sync inputs. Connect output relays on the Kisi Controller Pro to open input triggers on the ACM8. C on the Kisi Controller connects to the ground on the ACM8. NO on the Kisi Controller connects to NO on the ACM8. Optionally, wire other input devices like keypads and request X buttons to the other inputs.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out the description below for more resources. If you have any questions, make sure to leave a comment. Remember to click subscribe to stay updated on the latest in access control and physical security.